Okay, good morning everyone. So thank you very much to Stefan and Martina for organizing this very interesting event and for inviting me to present this little speech, to share this experience that we have addressed during last year, let's say following the works activities of the Stammer Research Project. My name is Sara Favargiotti, I'm an assistant professor of landscape architecture at the University of Trento, and this duet that me and Giovanna will present you shortly this morning will give you a short overview among the experience that are ongoing. It's an ongoing experience that try to show you how this collaboration among university research and cultural centers in the city of Trento are supporting and really exchanging daily with the municipality of Trento, and in this specific case with the figure of Giovanna. So I give the speech to Giovanna to introduce the context, our context, and some outcomes of the some general overview of the city.
Thank you, Sara. Thank you, Stefan. Thank you, Martina. Good morning to everyone. And thank you for the two so brilliant lecture I can hear. Sorry for my English and sorry for my poor ideas. I'm a simple worker in the office that is taking care of designing, realizing, and maintaining green areas, open public areas in the city of Trento. But I had this honor to be inside the DICAM project and to build a collaboration with a knowledge partner. We started with this photo of a suburb of Trento. This kind of Legoland is a real place where we start to collaborate with the university in Los Dama project and as bricks of this common knowledge that we want to share with you this morning. Trento is there, is inside the mountains, is the third city in the Alpine area. Internal areas and is 117 inhabitants, so a small village. Trento, when the lights turn up, disappear. And I'm not speaking about light pollution, but I speak about the need for us to find a correct balance of scale and identity. And about the need to be conscious for us to belong to an alpine road system, because it's not so easy for us to understand that. The orography of our territory, we have a very flat channel, valley, that is crossed by local infrastructure, green and gray. Actually divided by this infrastructure, and then we have a very close mountain in which there are few people that is living there. When we start with the Los Dama project, that is a project that is focusing on peri-urban, we start just thinking of a strange word: what is peri-urban for us? But we move from a kind of big problem, put a definition on the table, put boundaries on this peri-urban, and we move on thinking what peri-urban actually can be, and what peri-urban was for our community. This is a fresco of the Buon Consiglio Castle, the castle of Trento. In the Eagle Tower, there is this representation in the 14th century, was made of the city of Trento. It's very nice, and is a representation of the relationship between the city and the outside. And actually is a fresco that can make a perception of harmony and beauty with between the city and the surrounding. What is the perception of peri-urban now in the touristic strategic narrative? Peri-urban is not present because we are just a very powerful expression of the extra natural territory. If we face with the daily perception of our citizen, actually the idea they have is more or less that one, is okay, a little bit stronger, but is made by people that is saying that we lose land, we have too much soil consumption, and this is in some way true because we use all the space in the valley from the 70s to the beginning of the 20s because we actually put too much attention on the real estate, and in the Dosdama project we were able to change the perspective, so again to light up the open and the spaces, and to realize that we have a lot. We have a lot of external spaces that are mainly used as agriculture and woodland use, but they also have a very interesting way to be protected. All the system of protection, we have a common good and collect system of, for the middle age of shared property of land as a way to balance with private individual interest, and we have a very modern way to protect this territory as the we call rete delle riserve. That is a reserve network that is encouraging not only the protection but also the empowerment of economic development. What about the urban and peri-urban open spaces? So we take care of just a little part of it, but there is, as you can see, a lot of little pieces that they lack on good quality and connection, but they are rich in some way of biodiversity, and they go everywhere.
On this, based on this background, our research in terms of university and also in terms of academic experience that we offer to the students was really strongly interconnected to this context, this reality, both on the land side, as Giovanna really clearly explained, but also in terms of needs, not the city. And one amongst the main challenge that the city of Trento, as many other cities, are, have to face, like urban adaptation to social and climate resilience, climate risk, soil sealing, as infrastructure network, and infrastructure barriers that the valley is suffered. We mainly focus, also thanks to Los Dama, to this idea of marginality, not just refers to idea of connecting between marginal borders among rural, urban, some very geographical point of view, but something that is more inert in the city, exactly focusing on this spot that Giovanna highlighted. To approach this very challenging point, aspect, we share some aspects, some, first of all, cultural commons among our institutions, among our experiences. And exactly, commons for us, cultural commons for us refers to three main dimensions, the cultures, they are located in specific time and spaces, and physical, virtually, and share and express some topics, aspect of a specific community. Therefore, culture, space, community are the three dimensions that have been always involved in this process, this ongoing process, through several experiences that will be shown very, very fast in the next slides. And cultural commons for us is a system of intellectual resources, but also shared, as I say, by a group that sometimes could be find a connection, a mutual connection, but also sometimes can generate some dilemmas, some conflicts among each other. And it's made by the ideas, creativities, lifestyles, knowledge, of course, and participatory project, productive techniques. And within this framework, so the commons were based the theoretical but also practical frameworks of several activities. Specifically, as for our country, for our territories in Trentino, three are the main aspects that has been addressed somehow this concept. The first fair with the commons expressed the old new dimension of public space welfare. So it's based on it's an attitude that we have to somehow approach from these bottom up initiatives. We have deeply explained this through an article in the Journal of Alpine Research. And one of the main aspects is landscape. Landscape because reflects the lifestyle, the attitude that all the people have somehow addressed to the territories. So the landscape is also for us one very important commons that we share, and designing landscape, redesigning is very important through the landscape. And the qualities of the alpine areas, which give us a very specific and strong context that has to be taken in consideration for our approach. So this is somehow the common framework that we share. From one point, a political, let's say, framework. We have an agreement signed by the municipality and the university that allow us to interconnect research experiences and educational activities. And of course, Los Dama was one of additional elements or moments in which us as university, together other institutes, could be observer of their research and could be really facing a real problem that the city has to deal with and face also our students with these activities. And then we have a common framework more connected to the thematic, the issues and the topics that you can see here, these three topics that we will explain in the next slide. The ecological connectivity is really connected to the blue-green infrastructure, the urban gardens or and especially the unused land within the territories, and the network of and pathways of different kind of mobility that is required from the city.
Starting with the project, the Los Dama project, we found we need a kind of methodology, and we call our methodology an incremental approach. Actually, it's kind of random and messy sometimes, but we for sure start asking to all the internal department of the municipality what they need, just to focalize on activities that could be useful for the community and the municipality. And then we start working with instruments, GIS, because we have sometimes not good data, and with a lot of relationship with stakeholders and citizens, always having experts and university besides us. We were looking for a very pragmatic result because our politicians asked to that, and we need to prove that this kind of new way to work was is useful. And maybe this would not be so easy sometimes. Now we are at the end of the project. We are collecting all the activities that we did on the three main on the framework that Sara showed to you, and we realized that university was always with us, giving suggestions, sharing students, sharing ideas, and this is a proof of a relationship. Okay, that we built in these 3 years of work.
On the other hand, university really keep these elements, keep these, for example, based on GIS map and integrate it, improve it, try to upgrade and to integrate to a general system, and works also together the movement of students within collaborative workshops. Stakeholders, I mean, local researchers have been involved in the interviews during the academic years, and the cooperation has been always and still always ongoing and active to produce what strategic scenarios, experimental visions that could somehow highlight and upgrade the problems and give some alternatives, possible futures to answer to these big challenges that the city has to approach. And these are just a very resume map of some of the experience through master thesis or landscape design studios design project that have been addressing in these 2.5-3 years.
What about the first issue, the blue and green infrastructure? We start to look better to our territory, and we start from the most complicated, the northern part of the valley. And we realized that our knowledge was very poor because we're focused on the land that was directly under our managing responsibility. And so we started some research with the university, with professionals, and one of them was focused on the land that was not used anymore. And we collected very interesting data because we have survey on the possible use of land for the future that we share with all the department of the municipality for the social project, for urban new urban plan, for other different several possible use. We use in some sort of brand with the Dosdama project some process of designing that we have in this suburb. And this allowed to us to strengthen the participatory process that was not so familiar sometimes with our approach to public work. But also this produced a very positive approach with the community, because they start to think that they belong to some more important and sovereign local process. They start to be a little bit proud of the collaboration with the university, with us, and of their land.
As you can see, the process and the mutual exchange also across different scales, from the very large scale going down to the very small scale, and this is also the process that students has addressed. For example, this Christina was a student of work at the office for a while with Giovanna, and focusing specifically on this topic of green infrastructure, these heterogeneity territories of Trento North, and address and taking that the opportunity of an exchange, the new development that the city has planned, the province has planned for this conversion of this big hub, infrastructural hub, it takes opportunity to show an alternative, so integrative, let's say, scenarios that this opportunity of this transformation could offer opportunity for a new landscape, for a new part of integrated system with nature and urban environment that can offer more landscape, of course, enjoyable, but also new hotspot for a new inhabitat, and of course, among other aspects, a new cooling, a better cooling effect to the inhabitants that are living in the nearby. And of course, the proposal, the vision that they offer, we offer, and we are mutually exchanging with them, it's a new image, a new quality for this part of the city.
The second frame up was related to urban gardens. We were used in our office just to prepare those to infrastructure this piece of land, and then to give them to association. But we realized that with a survey that we had thousands of pieces of orchards all around and inside the peri-urban areas. And those are in some sort of stepping stone on the social and ecological strategy. So we started with students and the university to meet people that are taking care of these piece of green areas and involving them in some process of innovation in cultivation, and we make people speaking each other, and we realize with our survey that we have a social, urban garden, communitarian, social, scholastic. So there is a world under this very simple and simple way to have a relationship with land. After that, we give this information to another project that is Nutrire Trento. Nutrire Trento is Feed Trento. It's a project always between the university and Trento and the municipality, and is trying. He wants to make consciousness on the agricultural potential of the city and educate new generations.
Yeah, this opportunity of to work with urban gardens offer also was a great opportunity for the students of the landscape design studio to address with this very ongoing topic, very clever for especially for this part of Trento Nord again. We are working that, so this is just a very short application that the students presented for the final exams. They were it's very fast, but to see how the context of the elements that the quality of the materials, natural, the neighborhood, but also the social aspect has been addressed, and within a really connected and in interchange exchange with the municipality. And the idea is exactly this area where the students has been study is an area that the municipality is interested to share with this very common, with this common laws to be given to give into the cities, this very high diverse neighborhood. And so the idea has been to show somehow how the process could be addressed also in a very different way, in a process, in a long-term process. And well, I also have to thanks to Alessandro Retta, which was my colleagues and supervising this by supervising this studio.
Alessandro actually is the project manager of Osdama, so he is the person that symbolized this collaboration. The third framework is related to the accessibility of the peri-urban, because we realize that we don't have a system of connection between the city and the mountain. And so, survey, and we did that looking to all the network of pathway, looking also for the physical characteristic of them, because we are an office of works, so we were thinking, okay, let's address future works and future management of those parks. But we also enlarged the analysis, thanks to Rosdana, thanks to our knowledge partner, to the territory that was on it, because we have to change the narrative of those urban areas. So we have to start looking to the natural and cultural beauty that is a minor heritage that we have tap and to make a relationship with the corridor, with the pathway. We did that also with some open mapping campaign and with some knowledge partner. We work with school, high school, in designing and in just learning. And we produce also project, professional project, so we are ready to work, okay, with the result of what was done.
Once again, a student that has been helping, supporting the municipality activities to an internship wanted to address and implement this research project on the slow mobility, specifically focused in this big framework of this transformation in the eastern side of the valley. So she's addressing, she will present in a few weeks her master's thesis dissertation. The in-between territories has an opportunity to reconnect these urban peri-urban areas, really focusing and upgrading this analysis that she did within the municipality by adding additional perception, qualitative plus quantitative characters of analyzing the current pathway, the lacking pathways, the footprints that are existing, and exactly by studying, like a scientist, step by step, these pathways, analyze three missing interesting topics that could be proposed as new pathways to reconnect the general system on the valley. And then she jumped to a specific project that we propose designing a practical project to reconnect to part of this of the valleys that are not yet connecting now, by following the orography, the existing orography, the pathway and the footprint existing, and of course proposing a new project integrating with the nature and open and accessible to all. And this is also an ongoing project which the municipality is now addressing a more feasibility study, so I think also the occasion, the chance for students would be to go back to the municipality and propose their idea. So going to the conclusion, just a few slides to propose the lesson learned, what we have learned by each other and future opportunities. As I say, it's an ongoing process, what we are doing. We have learned a lot, so first of all, we would like to thanks Lostama to give us this opportunity to collaborate and strengthen synergies. And of course, those are the topics that our institution are facing so far. And three are mainly the most reflection and conclusions that we'd like to share with you. For us, it was very important this engagement, you know, the engagement of local actors, citizens, municipalities, and students, so to create this moment of collaboration, education, in which all of us learn by each other. From us, it was very important to deal with the concrete problems and to make a new practitioner, so the students, the people that will work in the city, facing with the realities, and this is somehow a way to educate, you know, new professionals, new practitioners, citizens of our world, but also like this dissemination, you know, to try to raise awareness to within formal and informal activities which students, both from master thesis, doctoral thesis, and so far so on, has been involved in during these years. On the other hand, we also share experience. It was very, as Martina mentioned, the students with Martina and Stefan has been used Trento Nord as case studies for their studios, and also for us, for they share their knowledge and their readings, their project, their vision with our students, with my students, that exactly we all learn from their point of view, and we use this as a first step to further development together with the municipalities, as shown in this picture when last spring they present everything. So this process is a very focused on a cooperative design involving a wider range of actors to share, consolidate some strategic vision for our futures. And last step is an exchange and involvement amongst partners to generate a strong collaborative process. And maybe Giovanna would like to address something specifically.
Yes, incremental and process, we are growing. And in the last years, we were involved in some European program and project. what I want to point out, that we at the beginning we were just a case study. We were just used to give data. Sometimes some researchers come and just need that. But what really changed the reality, our reality, is to work together, okay? Just to explain how we use the data and why we have need of this meaning and knowledge.
Yes, exactly. So this is the framework, just very briefly to show, as I mentioned at the beginning, an ongoing process. It's just Lostama ended now, but actually it's for us it's just a moment to restart, to continue this collaboration and to approach these common topics, of course, for make both in our institution, but together our city is better for the more quality spaces for us and for our future. So thank you very much.
Oh, I don't have a question. I want to congratulate the Trento team. I think I'm really impressed that when we wrote the application for Lostama, at least I never thought that it would initiate that much of collaboration between universities, cities across the Alpine bow, and I'm really happy. Thank you.